Welcome to the Best in Heritage 2020. Today we have Mr. Moritz, Kinzel, and Abdulhamid, Dihna, from the Istanbul Department of the German Archaeological Institute. Hello. Hello. Congratulations on the European Heritage Award of 2019 for the project. And we have a few questions for you to share the Stewards of Cultural Heritage project. First, you can answer any of you. First, could you briefly describe your institution?
First, thank you for having us. And our institution, the German Archaeological Institute, is now a 190 years old research institution that has in the center of its kind of meaning is to do research and to exchange knowledge about archaeology in the first place. But over the years, it became clear that if you want to preserve archaeological heritage in all the countries we are working in, it's about knowledge transfer and to raise awareness about heritage. So the heritage kind of awareness raising, capacity building programs became a crucial part of our work in all the projects we have globally, worldwide, and not only at the Istanbul Department, because the German Archaeological Institute is a research, international research institution that is state-funded, but with a lot of partners in universities and worldwide other research institutions.
Okay, thank you. What was the history of the awarded project?
The Stewards of Cultural Heritage program was initiated in a way in the aftermath of the Syrian crisis, and it is a kind of sub-project of the so-called Archaeological Heritage Network that was an initiative in Germany to bring together institutions, experts, and NGOs that are dealing with heritage to have a better kind of expertise in how to preserve and protect heritage. And in this framework, there was a project called Stunde Null. So it was an initiative by the Foreign Ministry, the Gerda Henkel Foundation, and the Archaeological Heritage Network. And one sub-project of this initiative was our project, the Stewards of Cultural Heritage. It was the idea to give Syrian refugees that made their way to Turkey to give them a perspective and to gain knowledge so they could return to the country and take care of their heritage after the crisis has finished. So to be prepared for the future after a crisis.
Yes, I really liked the word Stunde Null, a future for the time after the crisis. It's a very innovative framework of thinking. Could you explain what did you really impress the prize jury?
Regarding the Stewards of Cultural Heritage program, the jury states this is an excellent international of collaborative training initiative involving a variety of stakeholders of addressing an important current issue with pan-European relevance. The project addressed some of the complex issues raised in the hosting of skills, displacement, Syrian population in Europe, and it attempts to enhance their ability to integrate into the existing mechanisms that promote the separating and reuse of cultural heritage assets.
Thank you. It must have been a challenge because you have so many partners, and then, of course, working with the refugees who lost their homes and their culture. What was the most challenging experience and or even a positive experience you had during the project's implementation?
Of course. This project helped a lot of people as it shed light on segments of people by holding various workshops in several Turkish cities, so that our work touched different segments of Syrian. The cultural and heritage between Syria and Turkey is very similar, and it's close. Our many customs and traditions is similar between two of peoples. We had passes in which we shed light on the Syrian heritage, and the Syrians reacted with that activity a lot. The Turkish also shared this positive reaction.
I might add also to this that it was very interesting to see how suddenly some kind of a feeling of shared heritage approached or appeared between these two groups meeting. And also this the challenge for sure was to kind of bring together experts from various cultural backgrounds, also from Europe, from Syria, from Turkey, and try to give them a framework where they could work together hands-on on specific fieldworks as well, or study programs and workshops. So they learned a lot also from the different approaches, how different cultures deal with these ways and the difficulty of have replaced people, refugees, that had to also to find a new way or to adjust to the new frameworks in Turkey was also not that easy in the beginning, or in the beginning much easier, but now kind of over the time it felt a bit more difficult to actually arrange things within the framework of changing political also frameworks.
Thank you. Of course, that your answer leads to my next question. Did this project help the ordinary Syrian refugee communities recover the sense of the place and value of their own culture while residing in Turkey without concrete future?
Yes. The project, which has been inherited by the German Archaeology Institute, shows a great dedication to address the Syrian crisis by counterbalancing from the outside of the effect hindering the total loss of Syrian cultural heritage and the memories attached to it. The project also replaced one of the mission to address the refugees crisis in Europe and Turkey. It promotes preserving cultural heritage by supporting its steward, and it has been a promising German-Turkish-Syrian cooperation. Example for crisis national cultural heritage preserving efforts. Which is a shared responsibility identified in UAE, EU policies. The main ideas behind the project has been to support the five trained specialists as the actual stewards of Syrian cultural heritage. This is achieved through utilizing their rates and passing on the knowledge and skill they have obtained to other Syrian colleges in Turkey and another parts of the world. Hence, the project is means to have a broader effect, primacy but not actuality, on the wider Syrian committee.
I might just add some few words to this as well. So half of the project for example, an exhibition we had here last year where German researchers or researchers in Europe shared their old photographs from Syria with us, and then we asked the Syrians here in Turkey to write down or tell us their memories about the places they seen, the stories related with this. And this was then presented in an exhibition that was very welcomed also by the Turkish community here in Istanbul, where they also could relate to certain stories, to certain places. So it was not only a kind of a memorizing experience for the Syrian community, but itself also to make aware the Turkish citizens of the lost Syrian heritage. So they had something to share with each other and to know or to learn about each other. So it helped a lot also to further develop the project.
Yes, it's such a good example. You start with helping somebody else, but at the end, you're helping yourself also. So that's a very good example. For that reason, does this project enhance the awareness of refugees' cultural rights in armed conflicts areas other than Syria?
I think it's one of the tricky questions. This outrageous destruction of Syrian cultural heritage somehow poses a great challenge for our future, also kind of reconstruction of the country itself and all the cultural assets, but not only in a way to attract international tourism or as a big, important source, I would say, for income. But if you see the debate now also in Syria, kind of how might it to reconstruct or rehabilitate cities, it reminds me a lot about what we had in Germany after World War II or in other areas where you have a lot of destruction in countries. So it is more might be sometimes to start a debate to support a discussion amongst also the refugees and in the country, what does this actually mean for your place and how do you imagine your future? So I can really see that this is also might be a case model for other places that you could say, okay, with rising awareness, with training experts from the country that might can return then will help also other countries in future kind of. We have also in the German Archaeological Institute, for example, another program in Iraq running where experts are trained in a year-long project to be more aware and capable to deal with archaeological sites. And it plays somehow in the same direction of this our project here.
Thank you for your insightful reply. My last question is, could you tell us more about the recent and the third phase of the project?
The participants of the program include, in addition to the five annual awards and the coordinator team at the Istanbul, a number of international experts is the selection committee. Several Turkish, international experts how have eyed the workshops of the summer field project. These experts come from various universities in Turkey, Germany, Denmark, and Poland. As mentioned earlier, we had workshop directed towards Syrian and Turkish children, an oral history project addressed 100 Syrian refugees for interviews between 2017 and 2018, which led to well-received exhibition. Finally, the summer field project at the archaeological site of Dolce and Göbekli Tepe have include training for as well Turkish workers in the field of archaeological conservation. We hope that the number will increase as we continue with the upcoming workshops, which we are preparing right now, designed for students, Syrians and Turkish, to improve their skills in archaeological documentation of archaeological sites and damage assessment. In addition, the workshop for children helped to cultivate archaeological awareness as early as possible in their childhood.
Thank you so much for sharing your exceptional project with us, and I hope you have continued success for this wonderful endeavor. Thank you so much.
Thank you.